Today we are going to see the design of microprocessor. In that we see basic functions of microprocessor. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to explain the basic functions of microprocessor. There are two basic functions of microprocessor are. First one is the handling of micro definition and the second one is the handling of micro expansion. Now in this session we see the algorithm of processing of micro definition. Now the first step is, here we initialize the pointer variable. The first pointer variable is initialized here, SSN tab pointer. So here SSN tab stands for sequencing symbol name table pointer. So for that, here we initialize the value 1 to that pointer variable, and the second variable is the PN tab pointer, and it is also again assigned the value 1 to the PN tab pointer. PN tab stands for parameter name table. Now the second step is, here we process the micro prototype statement and form the MNT entry. MNT stands for micro name table. So during the processing of the micro prototype statement, here the name of the micro is there. So that micro name is assigned to the name variable. So the first step is name equal to micro name. Now the second step is, for each positional parameter, if there is a positional parameter is there, then we enter that positional parameter name in the PN tab, PN tab parameter name table, and after entering the parameter name in the PN tab, we increment the PN tab pointer by 1. So this is specified in the second step. PN tab pointer is incremented by 1. So here PN tab pointer equal to PN tab pointer plus 1. Now in the third step, where we write down the statement hash pp equal to hash pp plus 1. In the MNT table, we require the number of positional parameters. So that value is stored in the variable hash pp. So that's why here we specify the third statement hash pp equal to hash pp plus 1. Now next, in the C part, here we again initialize the keyword parameter default table pointer value to the keyword parameter default table pointer. So this variable kpdtp, this variable is come in the MNT table. Now then in the D part, for each keyword parameter, if there is a keyword parameter is there, then we have to enter that parameter name and the default value, if there is any specify, in the kpdt tab, means keyword parameter default table. After entering into the keyword parameter default table, now if there is any positional parameter is there, then that positional parameter is also entered in the PN tab. So that's why the second statement, we enter the parameter name in the PN tab, and after that we increment the respective pointer variable by 1. So in the third statement, we increment the keyword parameter default table pointer by 1, and in the fourth step, we increment the parameter name table pointer by 1, and in the fifth step, we specify, again we require the number of keyword parameters. So that's why here we specify the variable hash kp, and that value is stored, number of keyword parameter value is stored in the hash kp. So that's why here we specify hash kp equal to hash kp plus 1. Now in the E part, again we assign in the micro definition table pointer value to the micro definition table pointer. So here mdtp, this variable is come in the MNT table. In the F part, again we require the number of expansion time variables. So that value is stored in the hash ev variable. So that hash ev variable is assigning the value 0. And in the G part, again we assigning the sequencing table pointer value to the sequencing symbol table pointer. Again this table, again this pointer variable is come in the micro name table. Now the third step, while not a micro end statement, first statement is, here we check if an LCL statement, if there is an LCL statement, then we have to enter that expansion time variable name in the EVN tab. EVN tab stands for expansion time variable name table. After entering into the EVN tab, here we have to increment the value of the hash EV variable by 1. So here we specify the second statement as hash EV equal to hash EV plus 1. Now next we check if a model statement, if there is a model statement, then here we check if a label field is contains a sequencing symbol. If that label field is containing the sequencing symbol, then here we check whether that symbol is present in the SSN tab. If that symbol is present in the sequencing symbol name table, then we have to fetch that entry number of that symbol in the SSN table and we assign to the Q variable. If that symbol is not present in the sequencing symbol name table, then first of all we have to enter that symbol in the sequencing symbol name table. After that we have to take the entry number of that symbol and we assign to the value variable Q, and here we increment the sequencing symbol name table pointer by 1. So here the next statement is SSN tab pointer equal to SSN tab pointer plus 1. Now the next statement is here we assign the micro definition table pointer to the sequencing symbol table by calculating the value sequencing symbol table pointer plus Q minus 1. So here the value of the micro definition pointer is assigned. Now in the second step, here we check for a parameter, we have to generate the specification in the form p comma hash n. If there is a parameter, then we have to generate the specification in the form p comma hash n. So p stands for the it is a parameter, and hash n it is indicates the entry number of that parameter in the pn tab. The third statement is for an expansion variable. If there is an expansion variable, again we have to generate the specification in the form e comma hash m. So here e stands for it is an expansion type variable, and hash m it is indicating the entry number of that expansion type variable in the EVN table. The fourth step is we have to record that IC in the table micro definition table. After that here we have to increment the micro definition table pointer by 1. So this statement is specified in the fifth, MDT pointer equal to MDT pointer plus 1. So here we increment the micro definition pointer by 1. Now we check if a preprocessor statement. If there is a preprocessor statement, then here we have to check if a set statement. If a set statement, then here we have to search the each expansion time variable name that is used in the statement in the EVN tab, and we have to generate the specification e comma hash m. So here e indicate it is an expansion time variable, and m indicate hash m indicates the entry number of that expansion time variable in the table EVN tab. Second, we check if an AIF or AGO statement, then here we check if a sequencing symbol used in the statement is present in the SSN tab, then we fetch the entry number of that sequencing symbol from the SSN tab and we assign to the Q variable. If that symbol is not present, then we have to enter that symbol in the SSN tab and then we have to fetch the entry number of that symbol and we assign to the Q variable. And the next we increment the respective sequencing symbol table pointer by 1. So that's the next statement is SSN tab pointer equal to SSN tab pointer plus 1. Now next we have to replace the symbol by S comma sequencing symbol table pointer plus Q minus 1. Now the third step is we have to record the IC in the micro definition table. After recording the IC in the micro definition table, now next we have to increment the micro definition pointer by 1. So in the fourth step we mention MDT pointer equal to MDT pointer plus 1. The first step is the micro end statement. So here we check if SSN tab means sequencing symbol table pointer is assigned the value 1, then in that case we have to assign the value 0 to the sequencing symbol table pointer. Otherwise else sequencing symbol pointer value will be incremented by sequencing symbol tab pointer plus sequencing symbol name tab pointer plus minus 1. So in this way we assign the value to the sequencing symbol table pointer. Now next we check if hash kp is having the value 0, then here we assign the value 0 to the keyword parameter default table pointer. So this is the algorithm of processing of the micro definition. After seeing the algorithm of micro definition, can you tell me, while processing the prototype statement, which of the following tables are constructed? First option, pn tab, second kpdt tab, third SSN tab, and fourth both A and P. Pause the video and think about it. The answer is both A and B. During processing the prototype statement, pn tab and the keyword parent default table, both tables are constructed. These are the references. Thank you.